Hello, I'm Olivia Wayne and welcome to the SheerLuxe show. We have another fab show for you today with fashion, beauty, food, styling hacks and some good old chats. You won't want to miss it. First up, the incredibly cool Amy Appleton Dreyer is talking us through the style rules she lives and breathes by. Next, Valentine's Day is looming, and whether you're heading out or staying in, makeup bro Chynara is here showing you three easy to replicate looks, perfect for the ultimate date night. Later, Masterchef finalist and friend of the show, Lorna Robertson, is cooking up a storm in the studio with a simple and delicious three-course dinner. Perfect for date night, girls' night, and everything in between. And finally, Polly is back with some more really clever styling hacks. But first, it's chat, and I'm joined by Lou Polly, along with very special guest, Instagram star Karina Marriott, aka the style idealist. Welcome, everyone.
Hello.
Ooh, they pack it in for me. I am revved up, raring to go. Karina, thank you for joining us. This is such a treat.
So nice.
Oh, it's so lovely seeing you all. Lou, haven't seen you in forever.
Ages.
And you all look resplendent, glowing. A bit like January is done, which makes me lead on nicely too. February, we're kind of almost halfway through. What kind of February fun are you all doing to fun it up and look ahead to spring optimism?
Oh, Polly, I'm feeling quite spring-like. I don't know about you. I think maybe I'm a bit early with that. So like I'm thinking about spring fashion, but I am like booking holidays left, right and centre just to kind of tide me over.
Just every minute, something, just away.
Yeah, we just came back from Lisbon.
Yeah, which was so amazing. I think we spoke briefly, didn't we? Do you love Lisbon?
What's the pastry that everyone
bought? Pastel de Nata.
I did.
I was really like, how much better can they be? Do you know what I mean? Like, you have
really
some nice ones here, but they really are so bloody good.
It's the water, obviously.
Yeah, something in them. They just come straight out of the oven. I'm having one. I was like, I'm going to need another, like, immediately. They're amazing. So, yeah, just booking really fun little mini breaks. I think it's a good way to make winter go slightly quicker.
Yeah. But I think you're right. It does feel like we're almost through the worst of it. I think it's like the bad bits behind us now. Karina, what's your kind of
funny? Yeah, I was literally just going to say January is like notoriously just a really quiet, quite sad month, just like after Christmas. So I feel like I had like a cheat code for January and I was like, I'm going away. So I actually went to Jamaica. I came back feeling like really refreshed and I was just like, yes, like let's continue this. Like obviously I'm not saying go on holiday every month, but it just means like putting myself first, like booking things, like having things to look forward to, like completely changed my mindset.
That's exactly it. Like we're like, let's book our summer holiday. Like we're really last minute .comers, but it's like, no, this year let's have it. Let's go towards it versus tomorrow should we go away? Because then you've got that joy, that excitement, the build up.
Yeah.
Absolutely agree. What about you, Lou? How are you funning it up?
I actually had a really nice January.
Oh,
It's my birthday in January and had a really nice time. And I feel like because everyone was expecting it to be locked down and then we weren't and we could do fun stuff, I was like, okay, actually. So yeah, I really enjoyed it. But we have booked to go to Paris at the end of February, which is so exciting.
Well, that's very you, Paris.
Yeah, I haven't been in like pre-pandemic. So good 2 years. So really, really looking forward to that.
What are you going to do there?
Just the usual. Like, we just kind of sit outside cafes, watch the world go by, bit of shopping, enjoy, hopefully a bit of sunshine. I just really love people watching in Paris.
Yeah,
me too.
And
I think the last time I went there, I packed it all with sightseeing. And next time I go, I just wanted people watch.
Yeah, I think we're lucky that we've been enough times now that I feel like we've done all the touristy bits.
You don't need to go to Mona Lisa right now?
No. Yeah. Funnily enough, no.
But you have to do like the whole... and padlocks and all of it.
That's like when you go to Pisa and you do it.
Well, you eat
So yeah, just soaking it all up.
And also all the food.
Yeah, exactly.
All the baguettes and all the
pound chocolate. What a cliche.
My January, weirdly, I had COVID, so it just kind of disappeared.
Yeah,
it was great. Like before you knew it, I was like, well, halfway through. Yeah. I even did dry January. Because I was like, because I wasn't feeling well the first bit, I didn't drink. Mm. My birthday missed, so I didn't drink. And then I was like, I'm halfway through. I'm only going to go and do it.
Did you feel better?
Honestly, nothing. Like literally the biggest waste.
But how much do you drink normally?
That's what everyone says. Like I'm this raging alcoholic, which I'm not. But I guess a dinner, like probably like 3 or 4 nights a week, a glass of wine. Like that's it. Yeah. It's not binge drinking.
Yeah.
Is it? I don't know. A doctor might tell me differently. But yeah, I felt no difference. Now I'm like, all the wine. Thank you very much. Yeah. Like, at least I now know it makes zero difference.
Yeah.
Right, this bit I'm excited about because you guys are stylish ladies and I want to hear, what is your golden style rule, do and don't? Let's start with you, Lou.
Okay, my number one style rule, I've got quite a simple aesthetic. I like quite classic, nothing too crazy out there. So I think if you are going to dress in the basics, if it was just a t-shirt, jeans, trainers, boots, whatever, I think investing in your accessories is a really good way to make that look feel more elevated, whether that's your jewelry, your bag, your shoes, your hair, whatever, hair accessories that was, a belt. I think those pieces can really kind of bring a look to life.
That's an excellent one. And also, I guess, you can mix it up. You'll like look different when you're actually wearing the same items.
Exactly. Like, I feel like I could wear like jeans and a t-shirt 5 days a week, plus different accessories, and I would create different looks.
Yeah. Brilliant. Agreed. Love that. Let's start on the positives. Let's start on the do's. Why don't you take us away?
Yeah, quite similar. Like, don't skip on your capsule wardrobe. That's something that I used to do when I was a lot younger, when I would just go to Topshop and like consistently buy these floral dresses that like just were not like wearable or ways to wear. And now my wardrobe is completely changed in buying like basics, everyday basics, that it's so much easier to dress in the mornings now because it's like mixing and matching pieces. Like, it just takes the stress.
Yeah. Okay, good. Noted. Polly.
So my personal do for me is to always balance out something more form-fitting with a slightly boxier piece. I think I personally wouldn't wear something head-to-toe really tight. I mean, obviously you do what you want. I'll caveat this phrase. This is my personal style rule, but I think if you're going for like a tighter jean, it's always nice to balance out with a boxy blazer or something like that, or a tighter top with a wide leg trouser, I think always just looks a bit cooler. I think you can definitely do a head-to-toe baggier look. I think I do that quite a lot, but I personally
makes it look more expensive.
Me too.
I don't know why. The sleeves are like belled or like a really like chunky.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, maybe I'll change my mind at some point in the future, but I just always think that works.
Well, I think you probably will, only because if we all look back to how we dressed like 15 years ago, we probably thought that was the way. Now, I wore that.
I know. Oh
my gosh. I would say I agree on one of mine is that if it's high street size up, I just feel like that's always going to be good. And also, this is something that I've taken with me for my career for sure. Dress to make you feel comfortable and confident. It's irrelevant of the dress code. Like, if you see how we've all come today, it's just how we feel best.
Yeah.
And you can only project your best self if you feel good. Like, close your armor. So, you know, battle up, baby.
And people can so tell when you don't feel comfortable in what you're wearing and the way that you sit and the way that you hold yourself. You can tell someone's not comfortable in it. So you've got to make sure.
I always think, though, even if you're not that confident, it's always like a conversation starter if you're in an outfit like, oh, I love that. Where'd you get that? And it just like loosens you up. Absolutely. That's what I find anyway.
Yeah, I totally agree.
And also, well, I guess therefore on the flip side, what are your don'ts? What for you? I guess you kind of did a do and a don't.
Well, my don't is actually basically lose, but I've like spun it. So it's don't forget to accessorize. It's like, I'll spin it into a positive. I totally agree with what Lou said. Basically, I just think, you know, jewelry, belts, hats, things like that. I think I've got a picture of Vera Van Erp, who's like the coolest person on earth, but it should come up on the screen. But she's kind of wearing a black coat and a roll neck, but she's popped a cap on, some gold earrings and a kind of Chanel belt bag thing. And like, I think that look without all those accessories could be quite boring. Yeah. But with those things, it just feels so much more interesting. So agreed.
Karina, any don'ts for you?
I would say don't go for only like trend-led stuff. I think classic pieces is something that's really important if you're trying to build a wardrobe. I think we can get really stuck on kind of what's in at the moment and not really shopping like our own wardrobes. Mm. So that would probably be my number one don't.
Excellent advice.
Agreed.
Okay, let's move on. So, what have you got your eye on? I mean, these are all good topics today. All right, what have you got your eye on for the season ahead? I went a bit nuts, so we won't start with me. Karina, when you start. Oh, I will tell you, actually. Yeah, I'll tell you really quickly.
Yeah, please. Yeah.
I mean, I put loads, so I won't say them all. But basically, I have the Chanel black dad sandals.
Oh,
and
God,
I got them like 2 years ago or something. And honestly, they're battered, i.e. I know they're good for me. Mm. So I'd like to get a white version.
Oh my God, so I'm in reverse. I've got a white pair. I want to get a black pair.
Yeah, but I know I'll wear them. So yes, it's an investment, but it's tried and tested.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I'd rather have one great pair that I wear all summer.
Yeah, 100%.
And
and spring, let's be honest. So they're kind of, you know, multi-seasonal.
Agreed.
But I love co-ords. I've always been a co-order. Yes. Mm. Skirts, tops, so yes.
I agree with the co-ords. There's a green set, co-ord set from Mango at the moment, which is just absolutely
gorgeous. Is that
gorgeous.
The one Monique was wearing?
Yes!
Oh my god.
I saw it and I was like,
stunning.
Yes, stunning.
You look incredible in that.
I love sets like that because like they're comfortable, like the way they fit my shape is like, it makes me feel like the most confident version of myself. So I'm like, right, mine, add it to basket. Nice. I need it.
No, I saw that and I thought she looks incredible. Yeah. I mean, she does wear clothes beautifully. But yeah, I thought, I was like, well, that's only Mango. So that was great.
Yeah, amazing. Mango. And then I saw a dress from 16 Arlington.
Oh, a bit different.
A bit different in price points. Very different. I saw it come up and I added it to my wish list straight away. And it's one of those dresses, it's stunning. It's a knitted maxi dress. Ooh. And I love knitted maxi dresses, like the length. I just think it's so stunning. It's got feathers on the cuffs and this really beautiful like long collar.
They're pointy.
Pointy long collars. And I saw it and I was like,
this is me.
I need it.
It would be
I don't
forever.
Know where I'm going in it, but I will make
you need to create an occasion.
Because that's what it's about for me anyway this year. It's like, I want to be extra, in a way, dressed. Like, we were, you know, locked down for so long. Like, I want to go out. I want to do things I haven't done
before. You'd wear that for, if you love it and it's for your shape and style, and you'd wear it forever. So
yeah.
Take it off the wish list and add it to basket. Okay, Polly.
As I said, I'm kind of quite in spring mode. I bought a couple of spring things, but sticking with some more, like, wintry fashion. I've got this pair of vinyl leather trousers. I think they're maybe not real leather, they're just vinyl. They're really high-waisted and a bit longer. I'm quite into a slightly longer trouser at the moment. I think they're just really cool with like trainers for the daytime, but then you could also dress those up with heels and a blazer for the evening. I just think I would get a lot of wear out of those.
Yeah.
Good vibes.
And Lou, finalement?
I would really love to find the perfect suede jacket, ideally with a bit of fringing.
I was really surprised when Lou mentioned fringing the other day. I was like, ooh, fringing.
Yeah, I love a bit of fringing. There was a Nilly Lotan one. I think it was probably this time last year that came onto net and it was like £2,000. It was the most perfect shape, really like a light beige, like camel doesn't really suit me. I think there's like a range of kind of beigey neutral tones, which it needs to fit your skin tone. So anyway. And it's like the perfect kind of stonewash, but it was £2,000. It was just obscene.
Yeah. But there was the camera.
Anyway, I can't get it out of my head, and so I'm really excited.
Have you been
frantically
searching all the sites?
You know, all the resale sites as well. And I haven't yet found one, but I went into Isabel Moran a couple of weeks ago and tried on. It was more of like a moleskin, but a really cool shape. It kind of crossed over, came just below the hips, and then you belted it, just give it a bit more shape. So something like that, I think, but in like a suede. When you're making a purchase like that, you need to make sure it's going to look,
I was like that with my Saks Fox.
Like, you know, it's going to work with everything that you have. You don't want to have just like one outfit it's going to work with.
This
goes back to Star Wars, but I have multiple ways.
So excellent. Love that. Oh, I hope you'll get everything you want on your wish list. All right, thank you so much, everyone. Karina, it's so lovely to have you here. Please come back. It was so fun. And I love chatting to you two too. Right, next up, it is my new girl crush, Amy Appleton Dreyer, with her style rules.
My first fave rule is layering. I love to do lots of layers. For instance, this is one of my go-tos. It's an Estino London slip dress, and it's one of my favorite colors other than neutrals. It's like this yummy olive green color. And I just think it's really grounding and yummy. Over it, I put my go-to knit from Totem. It's an alpaca knit, and it's just got like really like oversized long sleeves, and it's soft. You can really wear it. I wear it a lot of the time, just like over workout clothes. Next, I put it with my Bottega lug boots, which I would say is another investment piece, but honestly, by the time I bought 3 knockoffs, I could have purchased these, so I finally did. I wish I would have gotten them earlier because they really go with everything. And as always, Tiffany Hardware necklace, it kind of goes with everything. And I got it in silver, so. All right, that's rule number one. So my next favorite style rule I like to play with is
really oversized proportions, whether it's long arms or really long pants. Maybe it's just because I'm tall, but I also think it's really flattering and it also feels a little more luxe. So on my bottoms are a pair of Max Mara trousers I got 80% off at, I can't even remember the website, but it was such a deal, and I love the button and unbutton all the way down the sides. My knit is from Totem again. They just have really great cuts and styles. And then I'm wearing it with my New Balance sneakers that I scored on eBay because they're always sold out. So, and then my Celine Taboo bag, which really goes great with everything. So yeah, that's it. Big oversized proportions. The longer, the better.
So my next style rule is combo dressing. And maybe this is just a result of the pandemic, but I love wearing loungewear, whether it's pajama pants or sweatpants. I love wearing it with like more proper tops and coats. So it's kind of like business on top, party on the bottom. In this case, I've got more Totem on, and it's their pajama pant, but also Ascino London and Sleeper has really good loungewear, and Lace Tan I really like. And on the top, I've got a knit from Ray Fashion, from Matches Fashion. And the shoes are Beak, which are one of my favorite sandal makers, but these are like these really luxe shearling slides. I also think you could wear them with the Birkenstock Boston or any other kind of casual slide. And then on top is this yummy Remain Berger Christensen shearling coat. It's really great. It was a good deal. I got it half price this year, so I went ahead and splurged. So that's kind of my favorite. It's like I'm half dressed. Like, am I going to bed or am I going to brunch? We'll never know. My next style rule is tonal dressing with a little pop of color. I don't wear a ton of color and I love neutrals, but once in a while I love to add either a forest green or a little yellow or just whatever the color of the moment is. So for me today, it's this Bottega Veneta olive green clutch. And I paired it with this cashmere, recycled cashmere dress from Ray. It's Matches Fashion. It's one of my favorite purchases. It's just so classic and it's really comfortable. It's like you just don't feel like you're wearing anything, which is kind of the key. And then some Bottega Veneta slides. So it's all pretty easy and I almost feel like the bag is like an olive in your martini. It's the perfect color.
For my final style rule and probably my most favorite, I like to combine something a little feminine with something a little more masculine. So for today, I have paired a pair of sequin ITMFL shorts with a silk Ascino London camisole. And then for my masculine piece, I put it on with a menswear blazer from Better Us. It's a new label from Julie Polipas. It's all sustainable and recycled, and it's really fun because they put your name on the inside of your blazer. I also like to do this with menswear trousers sometimes and a bustier, anything to kind of add a touch of either masculinity or femininity to my outfit. It's especially good for when you're going out, I think. So also some tights and a YSL heel. Thanks, SheerLuxe, for having me. I hope you guys enjoyed all my style rules today, and I'll see you next time.
I think every time you buy something, you should get a high five.
I made a batch.
First sale, high five.
Thanks. Oh my god, this pot is going all over my
webpage. It'll be on the webpage.
Well, what have you got there?
I got my puppy.
This is soup.
She just did a wee before I bought her, so you're safe.
What do you think of soup, Eloise?
I'm going to put her in my pocket.
Oh. Edible.
Oh my so god.
Easy. Stylish, classic, easy.
Absolutely nailed it. High five.
Welcome back. Thanks so much, Amy. I loved it all. Now, next up, whether it's a bold lip or smoky eye you're after, Chynara is the pro to show you how to do it. She created three easy date night looks on the SheerLuxe team this week. Take a look.
Thank you.
Thanks so much, Chynara. You make it look so easy. I will be attempting all of them. Now, I'm joined by Lorna Robertson, MasterChef finalist and friend of the show. She's here to cook a simple but delicious dinner in case you want to spoil your other half next week. Welcome, Lorna.
Thank you so
much. It's so lovely having you here. Like, I am salivating just at the ingredients. So tell us, what are you making? And let's crack on with the cooking.
Let's get going. So, we're doing three courses for a really nice kind of Galentine's vibe, whatever you want to do on Valentine's Day. So we're starting off with a really simple crostini. Mm-hmm. It's veggie, so we've got some pears on there, some goat's cheese, some thyme, some honey, really delish, quite light. Then going into a main course of linguine with some crab, chili, samphire, garlic in there.
This is really delicious.
And then for pudding, something quite light. You don't want kind of three really, really heavy dishes, one after the other. So we've got pineapple, which is marinated in tequila, lime, chili, and then some creme fraiche on the top.
Oh, we're going to get lit in here. Let's go. All right, so what do you want to start with? And can I help you?
You can indeed.
Amazing.
So we start with our crostini. So we've got some delicious sourdough here.
Can I pass you?
I've just got a piece in the middle there, if you pass me that.
Ooh.
Which is something I made earlier.
Yeah, toasted.
Just a little bit of, a really nice, you can want quite a thick wedge in there. So I've chopped that and I've just given it a quick toast on either side so it's got a nice brown colour. And then if you could pass me a pear, please.
Pear.
Thank you very much. And some of that goat's cheese would be fabulous.
Now this dish kind of reminds me of a pasta I had in Florence.
Delicious. I think it's quite light. You've got the cheese in there, but you've also got the kind of vibrant fruit that kind of cuts through all of that, so it's not too heavy. Mm. So we're just going to take our pear. I'm not going to peel it because it gives you quite a nice contrast of colours on there. But if you wanted to peel it, then absolutely fine. So we're just going to cut this into quite thin slices.
Lovely.
I think with date night food, you don't want something that's too difficult to eat.
Yeah.
You don't want things that are kind of falling all over the place, falling down yourself.
Let's keep it sexy.
Exactly. So kind of bite-sized pieces is the name of the game here. So we're nearly finished slicing this pear into quite thin slices, bite-sized pieces.
I may ask, like, the goat cheese you're using, is this all supermarket available? Like, we don't need to go the highest end here?
No, I mean, you can do. Yeah. I think the best produce you can get, the more you're going to get out of the dishes that you make.
Fine.
So we're just going to slice up our goat's cheese. I'm going to take off the end bit here, but you can absolutely eat all of this rind, so I'm not going to peel this off.
Is there a trick to this, like, cut immediately from the fridge? Would that help?
Because
obviously we're in a studio with lights, like, does that make a difference if it gets a bit melty? Or
yeah,
not really?
This has got quite warm and a bit bitty. If you just pass me a bit of that olive oil. Yep.
And if people don't appreciate the effort, they should not be your people.
No, exactly that. So I'm just going to drop a little bit of olive oil onto there.
Anything better than sourdough and oil? No.
No, absolutely not. And then we're basically just going to layer up our pears and our cheese. So if you can get a bit of height on there, then brill. And I think that people appreciate the effort that you've put into it, you know? And we'll pop another little bit under
here. I like
here.
That you said this would be delicate to eat. I mean, I just see pear and cheese.
Oh, it's going everywhere.
Okay, fine.
But fine.
But fun. But it looks good on the plate.
Exactly. I'm going to get some thyme, just some fresh thyme, pull off some of these leaves, and then we're sprinkling this.
Oh my God, that
all
looks
over
so
the top
yummy.
And it smells delicious already. Like the smell of the thyme, you've got that with the pears and the cheese. Delicious.
Mmm, yummy.
And then if you can just pass me some of that honey.
Oh, yep.
And I think honey and cheese work so nicely together.
Sure.
This is kind of a light floral honey.
Okay,
and
yum.
Also, if you wanted, you could pop that under the grill at this point.
Yes, I was wondering. And would that be okay with the pear and the honey? Nothing
totally.
Happened?
It would be delicious. You could, if you wanted, to grill the pear as well or poach the pear beforehand. But I quite like it as it is raw because you get the kind of crispiness and the freshness of that. So, yeah, that is a really simple, really
very
easy starter.
Simple.
So, for the main course, we're doing a crab linguine with garlic, chili, samphire, parsley, and lemon. So if you could pass me a clove of garlic, please.
One clove.
Thank you. Yes.
One chili.
And a spring onion.
Spring onion.
So we're literally just going to chop away at spring onion, our chili, our garlic, and we've got a pan of boiling water here. Sorry if you can hear me over the chopping.
So you've got the water going?
Yep.
Okay.
And I think we're good to chuck in our pasta now. So the pasta that I've used here is dried, but it's an egg pasta.
Oh yeah.
So the pasta that you get dried in the shops doesn't normally contain any egg. It tastes a lot nicer. So you know when you have that kind of mouthfeel of a fresh pasta, where it's kind of just a bit more to it.
Yes,
it hasn't got that
chewiness.
Like that slimy texture, which you can sometimes get with a dried pasta.
So this is a good hybrid.
Exactly.
Could you just use a fresh pasta too?
100% you could. Okay. If you want to make your own pasta, brilliant. I'm just going to pop some olive oil into this saucepan that we've got heating up here.
Okay. Oh, that garlic smells delicious. I mean, anything with garlic and chili for me
is good.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. And we're going in. And this is at the point, you know, when you go into someone's house and they've got garlic and onions yeah. frying and you're like, oh my God, what is
you
that?
Could,
it's
yes,
delicious.
That was
and you're like,
yeah.
it's literally just a bit of onion. But fine. So that's just going to cook away. And if you could chuck me the small bottle of wine, please. So I've just gone for a little rosé here because Valentine's.
But so it doesn't really matter.
No, if you've got rosé, if you've got white wine, something like that will be really nice. Just to add a bit more flavour. So it's super quick. Basically, our sauce cooks in the time that we make our pasta.
Oh, so it's all speedy.
Exactly. There we go. So literally just a splash of wine. I'm cooking just like a portion here.
Yeah. Just to show us, but we double up on them.
Exactly.
On the ingredients.
So as you can see, our pasta is
basically done.
Speeding along nicely there. Lovely. And if you pass me that samphire, okay. I'm literally just at the end of our pasta cooking. I'm going to throw in a little handful of this.
Okay, in the pasta pan.
So it just has a really quick blanch. And that alcohol is now cooking off our wine. So you're just left with the kind of flavour of it without the kind of harshness behind that. Mm-hmm. Right. If you can pass me the crab.
Yes. And where did you get crab?
So the one that I'm using here is one that you can get from a supermarket.
Perfect.
It's fresh. I've got a mixture of white and brown crab meat. Thank you.
Bit so more juice
in we
to
go.
It.
Exactly.
Like all meat.
So the two together.
Yeah.
Delish.
Powers combined.
Exactly.
Captain Planet.
And I'll pass
you that. Sorry, showing my age.
And now we're basically done. I'm just going to grab a small bit of parsley. Right, we're basically done. And if you could pass me, oh, I'll grab it here, just some butter.
Yay.
Now, I have to say that butter, I think, is something that you should splash out on. I think that it makes a lot of difference. So I'm literally just taking our pasta and our samphire and putting it directly into that crab. And we want a bit of that pasta water.
Yeah.
I know everyone bangs on about pasta water. But I think because it's basically to do with the starch that you have in the water. So it helps to kind of bring everything together, if you like, and give your pasta a really nice coating.
This is why the experts come in.
We're not using a kind of traditional, thick, heavy, tomato-y, ragu-y base. We need to have that liquid in there so that the crab forms as a proper sauce rather than it just being
bits of crab
floating and pasta. We're going to put in our parsley.
Oh, it smells divine, let me tell you.
Squeeze of the old lemon. Seafood and citrus are always good friends. You want the two of them together. And it again, as you say, it just really gives that kind of nice fresh flavour. I'm just going to pass you that. And if I can just ask you for a bit of salt and pepper. Lovely.
Not too much salt. Well done.
Because as
really
I said, our samphire, or so do I, but because our samphire is quite salty, there's plenty of salt in the water that we cooked the pasta in. Right, here we go. So we have our delicious crab linguine.
Oh my God, look at
that. Samphire, chili, parsley, garlic. That bit of lemon at the end.
That looks so impressive.
Well, thank you. I mean, should do this for a job, though.
Yeah, I was going to say, you are a chef, but the fact that someone like me could make that is just so exciting.
Definitely. A bit of pepper on the end. Happy days.
Any garnish, or we don't need it?
No, you can put a bit of parsley on the top if you want, but...
Oh my God, it looks phenomenal.
I think all good. Right, we're going to start off by making just a quick little syrup, if you like.
Okay.
That's basically going to coat our pineapple.
Okay.
So we've got some tequila in the bowl.
Ooh!
Tequila.
Some party.
It is. Quite boozy. A good squeeze of honey in there to kind of counterbalance that. It is kind of spicy margarita vibes.
Love.
We all love a spicy marg. And we're going to finely slice
I love spicy
chili.
Dessert, sweet things as spicy.
Same here. So our chili is going to go into there.
Now, not to stop you as you're cooking, because obviously I'm aware of the time, but could you use spaghetti? Like, what is the alternative if you don't want the fullness, or if you're you don't tolerate like gluten, or, you know, what is a good alternative?
Totally. There are actually some really good options out there made of rice, made of sweet potato.
Buckwheat?
Yeah. Buckwheat's very good. Lots of really nice buckwheat noodles on the market. I mean, it's a bit of a fad now, but courgette's always an option.
Okay, so if you don't want the spaghetti, we want the flavours and the sauce.
Yeah.
Great. Just to...
Exactly. So I've just taken the zest of the lime off there now. And I'm popping in the juice.
Lovely. Oh, a whole lime. That's going to be zingy and fresh.
Zesty. So just to repeat what's in there again, we've got some tequila. You could also use a mezcal if you want, which would be kind of a bit more smoky. You could also use a rum. That would be really nice. Kind of have more Caribbean vibes rather than Mexican. Mm. Some honey, some lime zest, lime juice, and some chili. And if you just pass me that pineapple... I'm going to very quickly just take the skin off our pineapple. You want to make sure that you don't have any of those kind of prickly bits left on there, because they will kind of get in your teeth. I'm basically going to try and slice it as thin as possible. Ooh. Essentially kind of like a pineapple carpaccio, fancy. I'm literally just going to use a knife.
Just do what you can.
Exactly.
But it doesn't really matter, so no pressure here.
As I said, people just really appreciate the effort, I think. I think cooking a meal for someone is like
sign of love,
romantic. Yeah. Exactly.
Also, you try getting a booking this Valentine's Day.
Literally. And then we're going to drizzle on.
Look at this.
Our dressing.
Oh, that looks so gorgeous.
So that's got all of the delicious lime flavors in there. We've got the honey for some sweeteners, the chili for some real kick, and a bit of tequila, because who doesn't love booze on Valentine's? I'm just gonna do a quick little grate over the top.
Gosh. Let's not tell anyone you've done this.
Nope.
In the office, so I can just
have it. And then you could just have it as it is. That would be really delicious. But for a bit of indulgence, I'm going to put some creme fraiche over the top. And again, I would definitely go for the full fat option for this rather than the kind of diet creme fraiche, because it's really not the same. There we go.
All right, let's get
tuck
in.
Oh,
I'm excited.
I mean, I said it was an easy eater, however, maybe it was slightly overcompensated.
Yeah, you know, sourdough.
I know, get a bit of the pear, get a bit of the cheese.
I will.
Do you know what? I think at home, it's just a hold in your hand and an all-in-one job. He's not bad.
That is so good. The mix. Mm. Mm-hmm. All try it and I don't know how to. That's so good. Mm. Goat cheese, pear, honey, you taste it
it's
all.
Yum.
Delicious, right, come on. It's this one though.
Linguine on camera. I apologise so much.
No, I'll just twiddle and twiddle.
Oh, there we go.
Amazing.
It's a vibe. Mm.
That chili's such a good... You know, chili's a bit annoying. Sometimes they hit, sometimes they don't.
Yeah.
That one is fantastic. Mmm, the crab. I just want to try a bit of cooked... what's this guy?
Samphire. Mm. Mm. It's kind of juicy.
Lovely.
Like it's got like a lot of moisture in there. It kind of pops in your mouth.
Oh, that is so fantastic.
Yeah.
Oh,
yum. See what I mean by it? It's a bit kind of asparagus-y, but like salty.
Absolutely. Big fan of asparagus. But yeah, that's a lovely addition to the mix. And go on, little bit of that, little bit of that. Mm-hmm. Zingy, refreshing. Ready
nice
for the rest of the night now.
Yeah.
Ooh, what a lovely, well-balanced meal. That was delightful, Lorna. Thank you so, so much.
Thank
you
so much
delicious.
For having me.
The recipes and ingredients will be in the show notes below. And for more food inspo, please do check out Lorna at LornaRobertson_. Next up, no one knows more clever styling hacks than our very own Polly. Take a look at these clever new tricks.
Hello guys, I'm Polly, SheerLuxe's junior fashion editor, and I am back with you this week to share a few new quick and easy styling hacks that'll make getting dressed that bit easier. So let's get going with the first one. Okay, so my first hack is for when you have a long line shirt like this one that you want to tuck into the front of a pair of jeans, but you don't want the bulk of tucking in all that fabric in at the front. So all you need is a simple hair elastic, just a box standard one from Boots will do. What you need to do is just grab the front two bits like this. I'd say unbutton the bottom, and then pull them together like so. Try and keep it as sort of semi-neat as possible, and then just pull the elastic around that bit, keep it semi-loose, and then just tuck that into the front of your jeans. And I can't tell you why, but you'll be really surprised how non-bulky that is, but you still get the kind of tucked in look. I mean, I'm really surprised by how flat that looks. My next hack is when your jeans are a little bit too big and you want to make them feel a little more snug without actually getting them tailored. All you need again is an elastic like this. You start by unbuttoning your jeans and then threading the elastic through the belt loop closest to the button. So then after that, you can loop it around the button and then take the loose end here and pull it around the belt loop and then round the belt button just there. That's gonna pull that bit tighter. And then you can just do up your jeans as normal. And then to hide that, you can either put a belt through or you can tuck in your top and just pull it over to disguise it like so. And then your jeans will feel a touch tighter. My next hack is for when your jeans are too small. So these jeans are a little snug on me around the waist, and all you need to be able to make them work without having to do that top button up, make them a little bit more comfortable, is again, take your elastic, start instead by looping it over the button, and then thread it through the buttonhole, like that, and then just pull that toggle around the button again, and it just means that you can do your jeans up without having to actually do that top button up, and it makes them a whole lot more comfortable. Obviously, you want to perhaps hide the fact that you have done that with your little hair bobble, so to do that, all you need to do is grab a belt and just thread that through and just do it up like you normally would, and that will hide the hair bobble really nicely. Alternatively, you could wear a longer top to cover it, or just do the usual tuck if you've got room and just put it over like that and you won't see the bobble at all. And my final hack for today is when you have a cardigan that's slightly too long maybe and you want to make it look a bit shorter, or you want to create that tucked in effect with your cardigan but you perhaps don't have quite enough room to do so with your trousers or jeans. So you just need to start by unbuttoning the bottom two buttons of your jumper or your cardigan. In my case, it's actually the three bottom ones just because of the design. We've got two ones close together, but normally it would just be the bottom two. So you just start then by grabbing the bottom buttonhole and pulling it to the button above it. So not the one adjacent, but the one above. Pull that little buttonhole there out like so. And then just grab this buttonhole that's loose, put it down to the bottom one there. In my case, I'm just gonna need to tuck these little bits under, but normally that will just create a tucked in shorter effect without the need to actually tuck in your jumper at all. And that is everything for today. Thank you for watching. Let us know in the comments below if you try these hacks and you enjoyed them. I will see you next time.
So that's it for today. Thank you so much to Lorna, Amy, Chynara and Karina, and of course, Lou, Polly, Maya, Amrit and Ali. On the next show, we have some more fab content with fashion staples from Marilyn NL, a peek inside the wellness toolkit of the seriously impressive Dr. Mariam Zamani. We learn how to exercise even when sat at your desk, and lots more you won't want to miss. In the meantime, we would love it if you could comment below, give us a thumbs up and do subscribe if you haven't yet. Have a wonderful day wherever you are. Goodbye.